What's up, people? It's your girl Adola. First of all, if you're a parent, I need you to move closer. This is the kind of video that I think that all African parents should watch, just because times are changing. I mean, times have been changing for a long time, but a lot of people are still yet to get on board. So I'm begging you, African parents, please, please stop trying to get your children to become doctors, lawyers, or engineers by fire, by force. Just let them do what they want, what they would enjoy, because I see way too many parents that are trying to get their children to live the dream that they were not able to live. So many parents don't even ask their children what they want to be. They just tell their children, this is what you would do. Hopefully no one else is still doing that, but just in case somebody is still doing that, please move closer. I'm very sure that by now you've seen the story of the 8 Nigerian basketballers who were drafted into the NBA. That's the men's professional basketball league in America. It may be more than 8 of them, I don't know, but these are the 8 that I'm aware of. First of all, this is the first time that we've had this many Nigerians. I'm like, father, father. But not only are we super proud of these players, whether they were born in Nigeria or born in the US, they are still Nigerians. We claim them. But we are also super proud of their parents who saw the talent in their children and allowed them to go after their dreams. Just so you know, it's a lot of work if you have a child that is trying to play sports in America, because you basically have to drive them to practice several times a week and stay until they are done, as in from the time that they are younger. So it's not easy, but it's worth it, you know. Also, not every child that plays well ends up in the NBA. The chances are really slim, so you have to be really good to stand out. So huge congratulations to these parents. They've done a lot of work, so we're really proud of them. Now, before I tell you their ages and how much they will be getting paid, I know, right? Based on the contract that they signed, please know that money is not the measure of success. I'm sharing this to inspire someone to explore what they want to do, what they actually enjoy, because you can be successful at anything if you're good at it. I mean, I never thought throwing balls can earn people millions of dollars. But that's something that they enjoy doing and they're good at it, and now they're getting paid millions of dollars. Amen, somebody. Also, keep in mind that the amount varies by how good the player's skill is and the team that signed him. So the amount that they're getting paid varies. So first on our list today is 22-year-old Jordan Nwora. 22 years old. He was signed by the Milwaukee Bucks for a 2-year contract, getting paid $2.3 million. Dollars, not naira. Azane, congratulations, we are so proud of you. And next is 21-year-old Daniel Oturu, signed by the LA Clippers for a 2-year contract, getting paid $2.4 million. Congratulations, my brother. Next is 19-year-old Isaac Okoro, signed by the Cleveland Cavaliers for just 1-year contract, and he will be getting paid $5.3 million. Azane, kai, father, what am I doing with my life? Call it the world, how tall are you again? Is it too late for you to learn how to, you don't even know how to throw ball? Anyway, I'm like, what? 19 years old, $5.3 million. You see what I'm saying? Your own congratulations is like on another level. And next is Zeke Nnaji, signed by the Denver Nuggets for a 3-year contract, getting paid $6 million. Six, as in, my brother, you have done well. And next is 22-year-old Desmond Bane, signed by the Memphis Grizzlies for a 4-year contract, and he will be getting paid $10 million. Aze, congratulations, my brother. And next is 21-year-old Udoka Azubuike, signed by the Utah Jazz for a 4-year contract, getting paid $10.2 million. Congratulations. And next on our list is 21-year-old Precious Achiuwa, signed by the Miami Heat for a 4-year contract, getting paid $12.5 million. Congratulations. And finally, 19-year-old Onyeka Okongwu, signed by the Atlanta Hawks for a 4-year contract, getting paid $26.4 million. As in, let me repeat myself, $26.4 million. Hey, whoa, father, why? Hey, father, what am I doing with my life? Hey, whoa, hey, whoa. As in, if somebody tells you that the only way to make it is being a doctor or lawyer, tell them the devil is a liar. Unless you really want to be a doctor, you actually want to save lives. But don't study anything just because they said that is where money is. There can be money in anything if you know how to play your games, eh? Now, the cocoa of the matter is, if you are living in Nigeria or another African country, to be honest, opportunity is not that many in African countries. There are so many talented young people in different African countries. countries, but they don't have access to the same opportunity that people have in Western countries. It's really sad. You know, back home, it's usually who you know. So someone may be really talented, really good, really skilled, but if you don't know someone at the top, they may never even get drafted to a team or ever get noticed. So unless we change this, unless we stop corruption in sports, we may never get to see people that will be making this much money in sports in Africa. Also, I don't understand, but I feel like Africans, a lot of Nigerians especially, are really vested in British teams like Manchester United. I don't know. I feel like, when are we going to celebrate our own? When are we going to Beti Wala Ruge? When are we going to lift up our own teams? If the government is not doing it, we need people that would rise up and strengthen the state teams. We need businesses that will get behind teams in our own country. There's absolutely nothing wrong in the world watching Africans play as well. You know what I'm saying? Honestly, I think we need to start thinking about lifting up our own teams. And to be frank with you, the truth is we don't have adequate equipment to play any professional game. This is even affecting us at the Olympics. So many times our athletes don't even start training for the Olympics until few months to the Olympics. You guys remember the drama that happened with our soccer players the other time? I'm telling you. Anyway, I shared this story of these players just to inspire someone today that you can be successful at anything. You don't have to study something just because they said that there's money in it. Study something that you enjoy. Study something because you will enjoy practicing it. And if you do it well and God blesses it, you can make money doing anything. You don't have to make 26 million. I mean, it would be good if you do. But the important thing is for you to be able to afford your life and live a good life, you know, and help people. Anyway, once again, we're super proud of all these players. These are just the men's basketball league. We're super, super proud of them. Congratulations to all their parents for all the hard work, especially the moms. The moms are usually the ones taking them to practice. So I'm pretty sure that right now the moms are like really, really happy. So we're super proud of all these players, and hopefully they've inspired someone today that you can go after your dreams and you can make money doing anything that you're passionate about. By the way, it's so important, if there is somebody that I'm leaving out, please put their name in the comment section. And I want to hear about players from other African countries, not just Nigeria, because I'm sorry, but Koledowo only looked for the Nigerian players for me. I've been telling him that Nigeria is not Africa, that we have people from other countries as well, but he has ear infection. Anyways, so if you know of other players drafted in the NBA that are from other African countries, please put their names in the comment section below. We'd love to celebrate them as well. You guys don't know much. Guess what? I'm just keeping it real. Before I sign out, I'd like to give a huge shout out to two of my favorite viewers. I'm sorry, but these are two of the youngest viewers of this show, for their birthday that has passed. But hey, I still want to give them a shout out. The first person is Yiram, who turned one recently. I can't tell you where he's watching from, but hey, he loves the show this much. Take a look at him watching the show.
Yiram,
this coming election is
86. Yiram, come back. You can't touch her. Come back.
Who was born in Akku in 1999?
You can't touch her.
Former president.
Happy birthday, Yiram. You are absolutely beautiful, absolutely gorgeous, absolutely smart, and we love you. Thank you so much for watching Keeping It Real. And the second person I want to give a shout out to is Isaac Badru. Oh my goodness, you guys know Isaac, as in, is a regular on this show. From the time he was born last year, you guys remember I talked about how his parents gave birth to him after 23 years of marriage. We're just so excited that Isaac turned one last month, and we just want to celebrate his birthday. Isaac, happy birthday. We love you. You look absolutely gorgeous. You is beautiful, my dear. Anyway, congratulations to his parents as well. Thank you so much for taking care of Isaac for all of us, because I feel like Isaac belongs to all of us. Alright, so happy birthday to you guys. And the last person I want to give a shout out to is another viewer of the show who turned 50. That is Pastor Shola Ajagwe Oshe, my personal person. You know, do well. He was the one that helped us in distributing chicken to people during COVID-19. You guys remember when we gave our bags of chicken and gari in Osun State? Thank you so much, sir. Happy birthday to you. Regards to you and your family. Before I sign out, don't forget to visit www.helpmewaka.com if you need to run any errands in Nigeria and in Ghana. It doesn't matter where you live, anywhere in the world, you can run any errands in Nigeria or Ghana if you visit helpmewaka.com. And don't forget that this is Christmas time and they can help you to deliver groceries to the doorsteps of your loved ones for Christmas. You might want to order on time. Christmas is coming. I don't know what you're waiting for. And the most important thing is, don't forget to use my promo code Adeola for a $5 discount. All right, y'all, it's been real and I'm keeping it right up in here. Don't forget to follow me on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram. And if you're yet to subscribe to my YouTube channel, I'm watching you all. Plasma TV, press the subscribe button. Until next time, I'm gonna see you later. Peace out.